Hey there, welcome to the latest episode of the Sexy Thyroid Solution. I'm your host, Angela Brown. So today I want to talk all about vegetarianism and hypothyroidism. But if you could do me a really big favor, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and then you'll hit that bell so you get a notification every time I release a new video each week. So let's go ahead and dive in here. I get asked quite often if it's good or bad to be a vegetarian with hypothyroidism. And I wanted to talk a little bit about my take on this. I've worked with quite a few women who have been vegetarian, and upon all the research I've done, this is kind of what I found. So one thing to consider is when you're a vegetarian, you run a very, very high risk of being B12 deficient. B12 is needed for so many things, especially with hypothyroidism. So you definitely want to be sure that you're keeping that in check. Something else to also consider is you can also become very deficient in things like iron, zinc, calcium, omega-3 fatty acids. Zinc is definitely one to be very cautious with, because we need that quite a bit with a sluggish thyroid. But some other things to also think about is vitamin A. Vitamin A is a really, really big one that's hard to get during vegetarianism. So you really need to be cautious with if you're deficient in vitamin A, because vitamin A is crucial for thyroid function. The other fat soluble vitamins also is vitamin D and vitamin E. These can also become very, very low because you don't get that much from plant-based foods. So keep those in mind. Those are things that you kind of want to watch for. Something else to kind of consider as well is when you're eating vegetarian, typically you're not getting enough protein in. So always consider that as well. You need a lot of protein. The amino acids in protein, you need those for hypothyroidism. So that can be a bit of a challenge as well. And also the thing is that I noticed quite often is a lot of people, when they're vegetarian, they load up on fruit. And as much as I love fruit, I think it's great, but a lot of times you're eating fruit and you're eating it by itself and there's no like fat or protein with it. And that can make the blood sugar go a little crazy, and especially not a good thing with hypothyroidism. So keep that in mind as well. The other thing too is with vegetarianism is it's really common, super common, to be consuming an excessive amount of soy. Soy is very detrimental for the thyroid. So keep those things in mind. Pescatarian, I've been asked about that as well. And that is just when you're just abstaining from eating all meat and animal flesh, like red meat and poultry, things like that. But you will eat fish. So keep that in mind too, because sometimes, you know, when you start, you're eating a ton of seafood, fish and things like that, and they're farm raised, you're not getting like wild caught fish. That can also create a poor situation with a lot of toxin buildup, things like that. The other thing too is, you know, if you're eating a ton of fish that have mercury in them, and mercury can be really detrimental for the thyroid too. So just again, kind of keep that in mind when you're considering, is this a good idea or a bad idea when you have hypothyroidism. Omnivores, obviously everything, they're eating plant-based, they're eating animal food. So you get a really good combination of everything. That is what I prefer for people with hypothyroidism, so that you get the best of both worlds. You can kind of lean more towards, you know, more plant-based, more animal-based, depending on how your body is reacting and what we would see on your testing. Testing is going to be a big determinant here too. I personally do a little bit better where I have a good combination of both. I work with quite a few clients who we have to have them lean a little bit more towards plant-based. So again, it's person dependent, but just thought I would give you some information on that. If you have questions with that, definitely reach out, let me know, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.